Hello everyone, welcome you all. In the last video we have seen the modes of heat transfer and the subsidiary law which governs the modes of heat transfer, that is, and the subsidiary law which governs the conduction. In this video we will see very small problems about that subsidiary law, that is Fourier's law of conduction. Then we will see the subsidiary laws which governs the convection and the radiation. Then in the next video we will go through the differential heat conduction equation. Okay. Right. In the problem, it is given that it is a 45 mm thick copper plate and the one side of the copper plate is maintained at 350 degrees Celsius and the other side of the copper plate is maintained as 50 degrees Celsius. Then the thermal conductivity value has been given. You have to find out the heat flux value from the Fourier's law. So, right. The given is given that it is a copper plate which has thickness of 45 mm and the one side of the copper plate, that is, it is maintained at 350 degree Celsius. I am noting it as T1. This side is known as T2 and it is equal to 50 degree Celsius. Now I am making this T1 here. Here it is T1, 350 degree Celsius. Now the temperature from T1 to T2 reduces. So from T1 to T2 the temperature reduces. So I am making in downwards direction. So 350 to 50 degree Celsius and the thickness of this copper plate is 45 mm. So copper plate. Now write down the given conditions. The given condition, thickness T equal to 45 mm. So make it into meters, 45 into 10 to the power minus 3 meters. Then T1 equal to 350 degree Celsius. T2 equal to 50 degree Celsius. Then the value K is given as 370 watt per meter degree Celsius. This is the given data. You are asked to find out the heat flux value, that is Q dot divided by A. So this value you have to find out. So what the first step in solution is, first thing, from Fourier's law. From Fourier's law, what is Fourier's law? You know, Q dot divided by A equal to minus K dt divided by dx. So this value you have to find out, that is the left hand side value you have to find out. In the right hand side the values are K dt dx. So K value is given as, so I am putting that minus sign here, the K value is given as 370. So 370 and dt. So dt means it is a T1 minus T2. In this case it will be T2 minus T1. Okay, T2 minus T1 divided by dx value is x2 minus x1. Okay, so this value is known as x2, this value is known as x1. So x2 minus x1 equal to 45 mm. So this is minus 370 divided by 45 into 10 to the power minus 3. Make it in meters, right? So T2 minus T1 value will be 50 minus 350 degree Celsius. So 50 minus 350 will be minus 300. So this minus and this minus will get cancelled and the answer is 2.46 into 10 to the power 6 watt per meter square. Now you can write it in the kilowatts. So 2460 kilowatt per meter square. This will be the answer. Okay. Now in the screen you have the problem number 2. Just read it. I will tell you how to solve the problem. Okay. In the second problem, it is given that it is again a plate through which through which the heat flow happens, right? So T1 is 150 degree Celsius and T2 is 45 degree Celsius, and the area given here is 4.5 meter square. Then dx value, that is the thickness of this plate, is 150 meter. Let me convert into meters. 150 into 10 to the power, sorry, 150 mm, I'm converting it into meters. So 150 into 10 to the power minus 3 meters. You are asked to find out the value of Q, that is heat flow, and the value K has been given as 9.35 watt per meter degree Celsius. Okay, you are asked to find out the value of Q. So again, come to this solution from Fourier's law. You know that my Q dot divided by A equal to minus K into dT by dx. Here you are asked to find out the value of Q only. So minus of 9.35, I am substituting the K value, into 4.5, the value of area, into the dT value is 45 minus 150. So it is minus 105 divided by dx value is 150 into 10 to the power minus 3, right? So solve the problem and you will get a numerical answer here. And the unit of Q is watts. So Q dot divided by A unit is watt per meter squared. Q dot is watts. If you ask me to find out the heat value, then it is joule, right? You just find out this value of Q in terms of watts and give the value in the comment box. Now we will discuss the subsidiary law which governs the convection problem. The subsidiary law which governs the convection problem is Newton's law of cooling. Newton's law of cooling. Okay, now consider a plate like this, and the plate thickness, sorry, the plate temperature is TW, that is wall temperature is TW, and over the plate some atmospheric airs are passing on. So the temperature of this atmospheric air will be TF, that is fluid temperature. This is wall temperature. Now the Newton's law of cooling states that the heat flux Q dot, the heat flux Q dot per unit area is directly proportional to the temperature difference between the plate and the fluid, that is TW minus TF. This is what the Newton's law of cooling. I'm repeating the same. The Newton's law of cooling said that the heat flux value Q dot per unit area is directly proportional to the temperature difference between the wall and fluid. Otherwise you can tell the wall temperature and fluid temperature, difference between the wall temperature and fluid temperature. Now this proportionality sign has to be removed. In order to remove that proportionality constant, I am inserting a constant value H into TW minus TF, right? This H value is nothing but convection heat transfer coefficient. Heat transfer coefficient. It is very similar to the value of K. The unit for convection heat transfer coefficient is watt per meter squared Kelvin or watt per meter squared degree Celsius. The unit for K value is watt per meter Kelvin. The unit for H value is watt per meter squared Kelvin. Okay. The values of H are given here. That is, this is for gases. This is for liquids. Again, this is for gases and this is for liquids. Okay, these two values are comes under free convection. These two values comes under forced convection. So under forced convection, the gases will have the value of 15 to 250 and under free convection the same gas will get the value of 5 to 25. Similarly, liquids will have the 50 to 300 of H value in free convection condition and 100 to 5000 value in forced convection condition. Now, in the problem, it is given that a plate has been kept at 300 degrees Celsius. This is the plate. The plate has been kept at TW equal to 300 degree Celsius. The dimension of this plate is 1 into 1.5 meter. So the area of the plate will comes 1 into 1.5 equal to 1.5 meter squared, right? So this plate temperature is 300 degrees Celsius and the fluid flows over this plate is at 20 degrees Celsius. So TF equal to 20 degrees Celsius, TW equal to 300 degrees Celsius, and H value given is 20 watt per meter squared degree Celsius. Now from the Newton's law of cooling, you know that the value Q dot divided by A is equal to H into TW minus TF. Now you are asked to find out the value Q. So this Q dot value, that is heat flux value, has to be find out. That heat flux value is equal to HA del T. So this HA del T becomes H equal to 20 and the area is 1.5 meter squared into del T is 300 minus 20, 280. Okay, now find out the Q dot value in terms of watts. So since it is Q dot, in terms of watts it will come, the answer will be around 8.4 kilowatts. Okay. Okay, now the laws for radiation. There are basic laws, that is subsidiary laws, important subsidiary laws for radiation. There are some other subsidiary laws also there for radiation. We will see in the radiation unit about those laws, right? Now the first law governs the radiation is Wien's law. The Wien's law states that the wavelength lambda m, that is the wavelength lambda m corresponding to the maximum energy, that is lambda at maximum energy. So lambda wavelength at corresponding to maximum energy, lambda max, is inversely proportional to the absolute temperature. You can write it absolute temperature. Now the lambda max equation comes like lambda max is directly inversely proportional to T 1 divided by T absolute temperature. Now if you make this absolute temperature to the left hand side, lambda max into temperature will become a constant. That constant will be equal to 2.9 into 10 to the power minus 3 meter Kelvin, right? This is the first law governs the law radiation. The second law governs the Kirchhoff law is the emissivity, that is the emissivity epsilon and the absorptivity alpha. These two values at a particular temperature, at a given temperature, whatever the temperature may be, at a given temperature and given wavelength, these two will be equal to each other, right? This is the second law. The third law is Stefan Boltzmann law. The Stefan Boltzmann law states that the emissive power E, that is the emissive power is E. If you substitute just like E, then it called as emissive power. Then if you substitute EB, then it is called as emissive power of the black body. The emissive power of the black body is directly proportional to the fourth power of its absolute temperature. Now this EB is equal to sigma into T power 4. This sigma is called as proportionality constant, that is Stefan Boltzmann constant. That sigma is equal to 5.67 into 10 to the power minus 8 watt per meter squared Kelvin power 4. this value has to be remembered by you, because in the problem this value will not be given in most of the times. So EB equal to sigma into T power minus T power 4, then the value of sigma, that is Stefan Boltzmann constant, is 5.67 into 10 to the power minus 8 watt per meter squared Kelvin power 4, right? These are all the subsidiary laws which governs all three modes of heat transfer. Thank you all. In the next video, we will see the general heat conduction equation in Cartesian coordinate. Thank you all.